हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम अगेन टू माय चैनल ऑर्गेनिक एंड हाइड्रोपोनिक अर्बन ग्रो प्रो। फ्रेंड्स, नाउ वी हैव एंटर इनटू द सेकंड वीक ऑफ द सितंबर एंड टुडे इट इज टाइम टू विजिट अवर अर्बन नेट हाउस एंड सी व्हाट ऑल अवर वेजिटेबल्स आर डूइंग आफ्टर द लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ द हैवी रेन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू विजिट दिस एंड सी हाउ द ऑल ऑफ डिफरेंट वेजिटेबल्स आर डूइंग इवन आफ्टर द हैवी रेन कंडीशंस वेयर मेनी क्रॉप्स आर डैमेज into the open field due to the damage. Let's go and visit the our urban net house. So friends, now let us enter into the urban net house and see what all is growing. Now we have entered and just see that lot of vegetation is there. So during this all the rainy days, all the vegetative growth is very excellent. The rain has stopped just couple of days back and today it is sun is also out. So hopefully the health will be good. Today we are doing the activity of weeding and digging. So this will make all the soil again little soft after the full rain and it will give a good aeration for the good plant growth. Now we'll start the visit from the left corner. Here our apple trees are there and you can see the apple trees have grown a lot. They almost reach up to a height of 8 feet and that is the top. So in the winter we'll top them and you can see that many of the branches have developed small pins. So there is all the possibility that this year we may get some flower on this apple tree. So we are hopefully getting some flowers and fruit this season. On the right corner, in this all the grow beds, we have three different variety of the turmeric. And you can just see the growth of the turmeric. This turmeric has reached almost to the 4.5 to 5 feet. And you can see that also now the new shoots are also coming out. So that means this turmeric is soon going to produce many turmeric from the bottom. So all the turmeric are not same. The last one is not doing good. I'll show you that. But before that, on this left side, we have all this cowpea. Cowpea is now almost touching to the top trellis wire. So we are going to pinch from the top and then we will see some of the flowering and fruiting. Here you can see some damage has happened to the vine and because of that flowering is already started. Some of the ginger left from the last season is also growing well over here. These are our red okra. They have just started flowering and soon we are going to get some red okra from this area. But we have lost lot of red okra due to the heavy rain. Here is our taro. You can just see the size of the taro plant and the leaf size of the taro. It has grown very well. Now taro is also developing new shoots and soon we are going to get the new taro setting on the all the bottom. Here is the second variety of the turmeric, which is around 4 feet, 3.5 to 4 feet. So this is also doing good. This is also developing some side shoots. So hopefully this is also giving us a good result. Only failure is over here. This variety, the short duration variety, is not doing good into this grow bags. So this is where we have not get the good result into the turmeric into this grow bed. Here is our regular okra and you can see the pods are developing and soon we are going to get flower and fruits. Meanwhile, you can see that all the digging work is going on. We have completed the weeding and we are now digging all around so that all the plants will get the good aeration. In this line we have different fruit trees including some deciduous, so they are growing well. With that we have planted some cucumbers and you can just see the growth of the cucumber vines. They are running very fast. Now on this cucumber I have made a video how to prune it and get the extra yield. And today I will show you the some results. So here you can see the cucumber bearing. This is bearing almost on the all the nodes. Here also you can see it is bearing regularly. Here we have applied some technique of cutting this cucumber at two nodes, but here only we are getting the one fruit over here. The second node fruit has dried up. Same way in this node you can see that this fruit is set, but this fruit has died out. So now onwards what we'll do, we'll keep only one extra node and remove all this other nodes. So here we are getting regular harvest of the cucumber from this vine, and you can simply see that the growth of the vine, it is very vigorous. Now into the second line, here you can see some pigeon pea plants, and in the ahead of this we have some brinjal and tomato plants over there. These are different variety of the brinjal and tomato we have tried. On the right you can see the elephant foot yam, and you can just see the growth of the yam. It has grown almost to the 5 feet. If you can compare with the person, so it is almost at the height of the person the plant has grown. Now in this line we have all these four plants of capsicum, brinjal, tomato and chili. Now here the first two is the two cucumber, then we have capsicum. We are harvesting capsicum regularly, and new fruit, flower and fruit setting is also there. Here is the chili, and next is the tomato. In tomato we have got lot of damage under the rain, which is a continuous rain, so we have taken some recut, and the plant are again regenerating and maybe giving us some fruits. But tomato is not doing so well in this season, so we are going to replace with the new plants. In this brinjal, we have regularly pruned this, and you can see just the height of the brinjal. They are above 6 feet, and flowering and fruiting is not as expected. Flowers are setting, but due to continuous rain, we haven't got many fruits from this plant. Further moving, this chili plant, this is giving us a regular fruiting. You can see the regular bearing of the chili on this plant. In between some of the continuous rainy day, the production of the chili was stopped, but now we are getting regular chili from these plants. This is little hot chili what we are getting from here. Now we are going to see all our ginger lines. We have again the three varieties, of which this first variety has grown very long. It has got the few shoots, but the color is not as we expect. You can see some of the exposure of the ginger roots are there, so we need to cover it with this soil, so that activity is going on. Next bit, this variety is doing good. You can see that the number of shoots are more in this variety, and the leaf color is also very dark, so this is doing good in this condition, and this is going to give us the good yield also. In the last variety, this variety having less number of the shoots, but the leaf are good, healthy leaf, and very with a good color. So we are hoping that more shoots will be coming out in this, and we are also going to get good yield from this ginger also. So friends, this is all about our urban net house as of now into the middle of the September. So how do you like my method of growing vegetables into this protected urban net house with all the grow bags and the organic way? Please write me back into the comment box. And if you also are interested in having a healthy food, you can plant some small protected house like this. Arrange your grow bags or the pots, anything, and grow your fresh vegetable like this, and have a healthy harvest and healthy life. Happy growing!